So far, we have discussed three advanced solar cell concepts based on the design considerations that we discuss in this course. We have discussed the passivated emitter concepts PERL and PERC, the TOPCon technology, and the metal wrap-through or MWT concept. In this video, we will move our focus to the advanced concepts for solar cells based on crystalline silicon that reach towards the theoretical maximum conversion efficiency. These technologies are heterojunctions or HIT, interdigitated backcontacted, abbreviated as IBC, and the combination of HIT and IBC, which currently holds the record conversion efficiency. The silicon heterojunction solar cell is the first high efficiency concept we will discuss in this video. Similar to the PERL and PERC concepts mentioned in the previous video, the front of the cell is textured with random pyramids. However, in this concept, the front surface is passivated with a stack of layers consisting of intrinsic hydrogenated amorphous silicon and on top of that, doped hydrogenated amorphous silicon. During the plasma deposition process of hydrogenated amorphous silicon, dangling bonds on the surface of the crystalline silicon wafer can be passivated very well. Panasonic named this structure the heterojunction with intrinsic thin layer or HIT, referring to the H of heterojunction, the I of intrinsic, and the T of thin. The band gap of amorphous silicon is 1.7 to 1.8 electron volts, while crystalline silicon has a band gap of 1.12 electron volts, and the junction is therefore a heterojunction. The PI stack at the front of the solar cell simultaneously acts as the emitter of the cell, whereas the IN stack at the back forms a back surface field. The deposition of the high band gap amorphous silicon provides effective passivation and thus low surface recombination velocity. In combination with the high band gap, the low surface recombination velocity of the cell will benefit by having the highest open circuit voltage of all high efficiency concepts solar cells. Charge transport on both sides of the wafer towards the metal fingers is facilitated by a transparent conductive oxide layer, as the conductivity of the doped layers is too small for effective charge transport. This makes a solar cell a bifacial cell, meaning that light can enter the cell from both from the front and from the back side. Light absorption of such a bifacial design will be increased as it can collect light that has been reflected from the surface underneath the cell. To ensure a good lifetime of the charge carriers, this concept uses an N-type wafer base instead of P-type to increase the lifetime of holes, although high-performing HIT cells have been made on P-type wafers as well. As already mentioned, most of the cell's layers are deposited using plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition technique, which will be discussed in another video. The most important advantage of this deposition technique is that the layers can be processed at a relatively low temperature of around 200 degrees Celsius, much lower than the 800 degrees Celsius used for the diffusion processes to make doped regions in standard crystalline silicon solar cells. This is a major advantage when handling the wafers, which can be made thinner, and it makes the overall production cost of this cell lower. The highest reported efficiency by Panasonic for the HIT cell is 25.6%. Recalling that the theoretical limit for the energy conversion efficiency of a single junction crystalline silicon solar cell is 29.4%, it becomes clear that PV researchers are getting closer to that limit. Before we move on to the record efficiency solar cell concept, we will first introduce another design feature for increasing the performance of a standard crystalline silicon solar cell. The interdigitated backcontacted solar cell has been another advanced design concept that has had a major impact in the field. Also, this cell design features random texture and an anti-reflective coating at the front to reduce reflection and has surface passivation. This solar cell design eliminates shading losses at the front of the cell by placing all the contacts at the back, hereby increasing the light absorption significantly. Alternating highly N-doped and P-type doped regions create small P-N junctions at the back of the cell for efficient separation of charge carriers. Secondly, by using localized contact, the metal semiconductor interface is reduced, resulting in lower recombination losses. And similar to the HIT cell, the wafer base is chosen to be N-type in order to increase the lifetime of holes. Instead of the previously mentioned back surface field, this cell design thus requires an N+ front surface field to push the minority carrier holes towards the back. Efficiencies of up to 25.2% are reported on the IBC solar cell design. When we take a closer look at the metal grid at the back of the solar cell, here shown as a top view in the figure below, it is clear that the cross-section of the metal contact is much larger than the usual thin fingers of the front metallization grid. Resistance in the contacts is hereby minimized. We also observe that the P+ regions are wider than the N+ regions, which can be explained by the shorter diffusion length of the minority carrier holes in the N-type wafer. Both contact regions form a back surface field that affects the collection of charge carriers at the neighboring contact. This is called electrical shading, and the P+ regions should therefore be larger to balance the charge collection. Having discussed both HIT and IBC, it turns out that a combination of these concepts is possible, yielding an even higher conversion efficiency of 26.6% presented by Kanika in September 2016. The figure shown in this slide is presented in the latest article of Kanika. Not all details are shown in this figure, however, it is clear that the design combines optimal collection of light at the front and reduced recombination losses at the back and front. It features surface texturing with an anti-reflective coating, passivation on both sides of the wafer with hydrogenated amorphous silicon to create a heterojunction cell with optimized VOC. All contacts are placed at the back to prevent shading at the front. Localized contacts are obtained by patterning the back with P-type and N-type amorphous silicon. And finally, again, an N-type wafer base is used to increase the lifetime of holes. To conclude this video, we have seen that the silicon heterojunction solar cell optimizes the open circuit voltage and has low production costs at the same time. The interdigitated back contactor design has all the contacts at the back of the wafer and thus increases light absorption. Finally, a combination of IBC and HIT yields the current record efficiency for a crystalline silicon solar cell of 26.6%, being not far from the theoretical limit of 29.4%.